So I am Agustina Satori. I'm the founder of GlamST. And at GlamST we do augmented reality for beauty companies. I started this company over 5 years ago. And now we are focused mainly in the US market with a big team there in Uruguay. Actually, it's interesting because I think there's a lot of ignorance in the world in general, about what's going on certain countries, right? And Uruguay is this small country in South America, really south, right? Very small, just 3 million people, and nobody knows what's going on there, right? Maybe they know we're good soccer players, right? But just that, right? And it's like we are not known maybe in the US corporate world about what is going on in Uruguay, right? Which I understand, because it's like if I change my mind and I say, okay, I would live in the US, maybe you have known nothing about a smaller country. So it's like for us, our technology team is like the biggest asset we have. The people we found in Uruguay are amazing. And I think companies in the US are deeply impressed when they talk with the team members from Uruguay and the amount of things that they know and like their skills. And many times we heard US technical people say, wow, your engineers could be an engineer of Silicon Valley, right? And then you're like, yeah, I'm proud of them. I know they could be an engineer of Silicon Valley. Like I talk with engineers here and I say, hey, like they are similar, right? And the same happens with entrepreneurs, right? The same happened to me. When I came here, I felt like maybe I was less than the rest because I didn't know what was going on in Silicon Valley. And this was the most competitive place in the world and the best place where best entrepreneurs exist here, right? And then you meet them and you're like, wait a minute, I'm not that different. Like, I'm not that different. I feel I'm as smart as any of them. I feel like I can build the same stuff. And also, I have a huge visibility of what's going on in other places of the world. So you're actually, if you actually break through, you are in an advantage, right? So again, I think for our team in Uruguay, for us it was important, the bonds that we have with local universities in Uruguay, how we started building our team through our networks, how each one of them knows certain important people in Uruguay. Many of them are like very skilled engineers that know about computer vision, AI, AR. People that here in San Francisco are like at the same level, you know? And in Uruguay, like just as an example, like software is the second biggest industry of the country. So it's huge. And there are universities that teach, and there are people that actually travel and go back. They go to the PhD, they go back, they do a master's, they go back. So there's a lot of people that actually know a lot about technology. And this is like an education thing that I always try to address with clients and investors, because they need to know that our team is incredible and that this is the reason why we could build what we could build. And honestly, like if you think about the resources that you need and how we built our team, it would have been maybe much harder to build this team in Silicon Valley. So I feel like it's this, like, you know, our team is this little diamond that we have, and that it's them who allowed us to get so far.